So today what we'll do is we'll once again see what all we have learnt in addition. We'll do a quick revision on addition and solve some problems on it, so you all know what we have learnt, okay, and you can remember easily what we have learnt. All right, so let's start with the revision class. So first we saw what is addition. What is the meaning of addition? Addition means combining two or more numbers together to find the sum or a total. Okay, so for example, if I have two balloons with me and you all have six balloons with you all, so to find out how many balloons all of us all together have, what we'll do is we'll add all the balloons together. So two my balloons and six your balloons, so 2 plus 6 gives us 8 balloons, right? So this is what is addition, combining two or more numbers together to find a sum. Okay, so finding the total or sum by combining two or more numbers. So we saw different types of additions also. So here what we are going to see, here we have two sheeps in a farm. Okay, there were two sheeps in a farm. Then what happened? Another sheep came and joined them in the farm. Now, how many sheeps are there in the farm altogether? Two, and the one which joined them, one. So 2 plus 1, 3 sheeps. Correct. So 2 and 1 makes 3. So 2 and 1 makes 3. Here and represents addition, or add mean, and means to add. Okay, so we write it as plus sign. So this is the plus sign, or this is the addition symbol. And we read it as 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Okay, how do you read it? You read it as 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Okay, then you can also write it like this in column, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Okay, so this is how, what is addition and how you write addition problems. Okay, then we saw the first method of addition, that was count and add. So what is the meaning of count and add? They'll give you some pictures of some images. You need to count those objects, how many objects are there, and then right. Okay, so here we had some bicycles, correct? So we counted. So how many are there here? In the first one, we have 5. In the second, we have 3. So 5 plus 3 will be equal to 8. Alright, so 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. Then here we have some bananas. To find the total number of bananas, you'll add them. So in the first set, we have 5 bananas. In the second, we have 4. So 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Okay, and then here we have some oranges. In the first set, we have 4 oranges. In the second, we have 3. So 4 plus 3. So when you add them and count and add them, you'll get 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. Okay, then we saw various examples. Here we have these 4 plus 4, which is equal to 8. Then we counted the number of hats. So how many hats are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hats. So 2 plus 3 is 5. And here we had some colorful eggs, right? So in the first we had 3, and in the second set we had 6 eggs. So 3 plus 6 is equal to 9. Okay, then we did add by counting fingers. So how will you do addition by counting fingers? Here we have 5 plus 3 or 3 plus 5. So in one hand you will hold 3 fingers, in another hand you will hold 5 fingers and then count. So 3 plus 5 will give you an 8. Okay, so now you're holding totally 8 fingers in your hand. So 3 plus 5 is 8. So same way we did so many examples. So we saw 3 plus 1. So if you hold 3 in your hand and then we are doing plus 1. So if you add one more finger to it, now how many fingers you have total open? You have 4 fingers. So 3 plus 1, 4. Same way now, if you open 2 fingers in one hand, then they've told 2 plus 2. So you'll add 2 more, open 2 more fingers. So when you do that, you'll have totally 4 fingers open, which is 2 plus 2, 4. Okay, and then now 2 plus 1. So take 2 fingers in one hand and then add one more finger to that. So now how many fingers are open? 3. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So we saw various examples on adding with fingers also. Then we saw another method, addition using tally marks. Right, addition using tally marks. What are tally marks? Tally marks are nothing but lines like this. So here we have 5. So since the number is 5, we will draw 5 tallies. These lines are called tallies. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then 5 plus 2 they have told. So 2, so we will draw 2 tallies. 1, 2. So 5 plus 2 is equal to how much? Now we will count all the tallies. So how do you count it? You can just write numbers above the tally. So this is 1, then this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. Correct. Then after 5 we have 6. So this will be 6 and this will be 7. So how many are there in total? We have 7 tallies in total. So 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. Okay, then we saw various examples here also. Then we have 7 plus 3 here. So now when you count tallies here, so first you will draw 7 tallies for 7. So here we have 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7. Correct. Then here we have 3 tallies. So we'll count that also. So 8, then that is 9, and the last one is 10. So 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. Okay. Like this only we saw various questions. Now 2 plus 5 is there here. Right. So 2 plus 5. So what you will do, you will draw 2 tallies first. So this is 1 and this is 2. Then here you will draw 5 tallies because they have given 2 plus 5. So 1, 2, 3, this is 4. And this is 5. So 2 plus 5. When you count, you'll get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 2 plus 5 is 7. And 5 plus 3. Same way here, you'll draw 5 tallies and 3 tallies. So 5 plus 3, you'll get 5, 6, 7, 8. So your answer is 8. So 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. Alright. And we saw so many examples for that. Now, then we saw adding zeros. What are adding zeros? Correct. So what are adding zeros? Adding zero means whenever you add zero to another number, you'll get the answer as a number itself, because zero means nothing. So when you're adding zero to a number, you're adding nothing, so it will be the number itself. So 3 plus 0, so 0 means nothing, so there's nothing here. So 3 plus 0 will give you 3 only, not more, not less. It will be 3 only. Okay, then we saw 2 plus 0. So how much is 2 plus 0? 2 plus 0 will be 2. Okay, and then we saw 0 plus 1. How much is 0 plus 1? 0 plus 1 will be 1. Then 0 plus 5. 0 plus 5 also will be 5 only. 0 plus 2, it will be 2. And 1 plus 0 will be equal to 1. So let's solve these questions that are there. 0 plus 9. How much is 0 plus 9? 0 plus 9 will be 9. And 2 plus 0, 2 plus 0 will be 2. 0 plus 8 will be 8. 0 plus 6 will be 6. 1 plus 0 is 1. 7 plus 0 will be 7 only. 5 plus 0 is 5. 10 plus 0 is 10. 0 plus 2 is 2. 0 plus 1 is 1. 6 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 3 is 0. 0 plus 3 is 3, 4 plus 0 is 4, 0 plus 1 is 1, and 9 plus 0 is 9. Okay, so this is adding 0. Whenever you add any number to 0, you'll get the number itself as the answer. Okay, then we saw addition on number line. So we did adding on number line. So we have 3 plus 4 here. So first what you'll do, if you're starting from 0, from 0 you'll go to 3, and then from 3 you'll count to 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 3 plus 4 gives you a 7. Right? Then we saw so many other examples. So first you start from 0. From 0 you jump to the next number. So here they have given 3 plus 3. So from 0 we'll jump to 3. Then plus 3 they have told. So we'll count in steps to 3. So 1, 2 and 3. So how much is 3 plus 3? 3 plus 3 gives you a 6. Okay, same way now they've told here 2 plus 2 also. So for 2 plus 2, you jump to 2 first. Right, you jump to 2 first. And then you'll add in steps of 2. So steps of 1. So 1, 2. So 2 plus 2 is 4. Okay, so that is 2 plus 2. So this is how you do addition using number line. Then we saw addition stories. What are addition stories? They'll give you a few stories on numbers and then you have to add and find all together or the sum. So here we saw so many examples. So there are 6 birds sitting on a tree. 3 more come and join. Okay, how many birds are there in all? So there were 6 birds on a tree. Okay, so 3 more came there. So 6 plus 3 is how many? 9. So there are 9 birds there now. So John had 7 coins. His father gave him 3 more. How many coins does John have now? So 7 he had already. Then his father gave him 3 coins. So 7 plus 3, now he has 10 coins. Okay, now Joe has balloons and 5 balloons and Mary has 6. How many balloons they have in all? That is 5 plus 6 is equal to 11. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll see a few questions on additions.